Very excited to welcome our first guest of the day. She's making her Hallmark debut. While we've seen him in such movies as Harvest Love and Unleashing Mr. Darcy, their new movie together, Hope at Christmas, premieres this Tuesday night at Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. Please welcome Scotty Thompson and Ryan Pavey. Yeah. Welcome, guys. Welcome. Look at this beautiful Hallmark couple right here. You guys are fantastic. I'm already feeling the movie.
I'm buying it.
I'm already buying the movie.
I love it.
You know, and this is another thing that I love about this film. A lot of times when we go out to do these movies, we kind of show up and we get to work right away. It's like day one, you get to know everybody. But luckily, you guys had a chance to kind of bond. You had a little bit of a bonding adventure, we'll say.
Yeah. We had a couple of days before filming began, and she and I never worked together. I never even really spoke before the project.
Oh, really?
And I am like Mr. Outdoorsy, hike, whatever. And I was like, hey, I'm gonna go do this thing. Do you wanna go hang out? And so we did. We went on this crazy adventure. I went hiking. I took her up to Joffrey Lakes, which has kind of become something of a tradition for me when I'm up that way, because it's just stunningly beautiful. I think we got some pictures.
I mean, Ryan, I can't believe that's a real photo.
That's a real place. I didn't even do anything to it. That place is just sitting there right now looking like that.
I mean,
that's breathtaking.
Granted, it's probably a little colder right now than it was then.
A little bit.
It might be.
That's pretty mind-blowing.
Did you love it?
Yeah.
So beautiful.
Yeah.
Yes. And, you know, I was like, I'm an outdoorsy person. I'm all about it, and went on the hike, and then...
Oh, yeah.
Jump in the water, a glacial lake.
But you brought your swimsuit.
Like,
this is glacial water up here.
This is melted ice.
How cold was it?
It was like 33 degrees.
Oh, you are. Oh, it's happening. She's moving quickly.
I'm out. But it was so refreshing. It felt so good. It's like I'm alive.
But after watching that, it really explains the amazing chemistry you have on screen because it's palpable. You can tell that the two of you really do like each other. Now, Sydney and Mac come together, your characters, at a time of sort of loss. They both had some big loss in their life, and that's how they sort of connect, right?
Yes, definitely. So Sydney has a daughter who is played by the beautiful, amazing, awesome Erica Tremblay. But she's also she's recently gone through a divorce. So she's heading home to pack up her grandmother's home. Her grandmother's passed away, so there's a lot of loss and change going through, and she's at this point of, you know, she thinks she's just going to come home and head back to the big city. But she
runs into me.
Yes.
Along comes Mac.
Yeah, along comes Mac.
Also has some loss.
Yeah. Mac's wife passed some time back, and I think he's just kind of settled into, I'm going to help the people in my community. I'm going to do my thing. I'm not necessarily actively looking for love, but you know, I mean, I think we try to stay open to what comes our way. And,
sure.
And we meet, and I think there's...
Room to rediscover.
Yeah.
Room to rediscover. However, while you guys are rediscovering one another, you're also trying to convince each other just how happy you are being single.
Oh, yeah. We do a really, really good job, too, of convincing ourselves that
like,
this is a thing that we want.
I know that I don't want to be with
you. Yeah, and you get to do whatever you want.
I just want to live how I want to live.
Let's let the people see.
Yeah. Not
take a look at this.
At all.
I've only been divorced a year, and already everybody wants me to get married again.
I don't know about you, but I like being single.
So do I. You can do whatever you want.
Whatever you want.
And you don't have to have some big discussion about what movie to go see.
Exactly, or what toppings you want to put on your pizza.
And if you want to wake up in the middle of the night and dance around in the living room to your favorite song, you can.
Yes, you can. You can do that.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's good to be alone.
Yeah, it is. It is good to be alone.
Did you do that?
What?
Dance around in the middle of the night in your living room?
Sometimes, yeah. Why are you looking at me
nothing,
like that?
Nothing, so do I.
No, you don't.
No, you're right, I don't, but I could.
Yeah, I'd like to see that.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, that was sweet.
I want to see these movies, I love them already.
I'll put in a good word.
Yeah.
People. I might just do it. I don't know. I might just do it.
Okay.
Well,
we'll get some video. We'll play it on
security cameras will go off. It'll be a thing.
It's not good.
Another thing that you guys obviously appreciate about this film is the fact that it promotes the joy of reading.
Yeah.
Right? Tell us about that.
Definitely. So the memory that Sydney has of growing up and spending time at this in the town with her grandmother when she was a child was going to the Book Bee, which is owned by Bee. I don't know her last name, but she owns this wonderful bookstore, and it's very charming and beautiful. And so when she comes back to town, it's still there. And Sydney ends up spending a lot of time there and starts to work there, and she really cares about it. Obviously, she has a daughter who,
right.
you know, education's really yeah. important, and so that's where she bumps into Mac,
into
actually.
This guy. Into mm-hmm. this guy, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mac's sort of a local fixture as well. B is kind of the unofficial local governor. She's got her eye on yeah. kind of everything.
Bit
B
of a
kind
matchmaker.
Of runs the place a little
nice.
Bit. She's a mischievous matchmaker mm-hmm. too. She doesn't seem to want anybody to be alone. But yeah, yeah. I mean, Mac being a school teacher, I spent a bit of time around the bookstore as well, so that mm-hmm. I've got some material to distribute to my students, which is how we meet.
Yep, right. He's a thief.
He is not a thief. We have a system in place, mm-hmm. I'll have you know.
Yeah, well, I'm a big city girl, and I don't know what's the small town rules. So I get educated, pun intended, on that one.
Well, speaking of education, you just did something that was really wonderful. You just took a trip to Africa, excuse me, to help educate the children over there and the women, and you got to introduce these kids to books and crafts and things that they had never even seen before. Scotty, this is amazing.
Yeah, it was really a beautiful. I work with this nonprofit called Build On, and you fundraise to go build an elementary school in villages. I've been to Nepal and Haiti before, and this year I went to Malawi and just got back from there a few days ago. It's a bit jet lagged.
Wow.
But yeah, you Jeez, live in a village with the villagers, and you know, you bring a gift, a small gift for the family. And I brought a pack of 64 crowns, and next thing I know, the whole village is there. You know, I think about all the packs of crowns I've gone through right. in my life and, like, haven't even thought about, and one pack is just for the whole village, and everyone just couldn't believe it, and their construction paper and
they'd never even
and
seen
drawing.
Crayons.
I don't think they had. Oh. It was mind-blowing.
That's amazing. Yeah. And I know neither of you like to really kind of toot your own horn when it comes to volunteering and giving back, but Ryan, you recently spent some time volunteering.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we're
around. Need your help.
Yeah, we're going through something locally that I didn't travel quite as far for, but you know, I mean, California's undergoing wildfires of a level we've never experienced before.
No.
And so, you know, I spent a fair bit of time recently donating and you know, materials, but also manpower as well to a couple of places for relief for the firefighters themselves, and then tomorrow and ongoing, I have some friends who have warehouses and stuff like that. I gave someone a link to an Amazon site where you can deliver things for evacuee relief as well. No. Basic stuff, toothpaste, T-shirts,
yeah.
stuff like that.
Cool.
People have lost everything.
That's amazing.
Chapstick.
Yeah.
Little things that you take for granted that they no longer have.
I love seeing how many people turned out.
I know.
I have to say the response has been overwhelming.
That's pretty
right.
amazing.
Yeah. You're really good. Thank you. I mean, seriously, thank you for all that you've been doing. So last time you were here, on a little bit of a lighter note.
Yeah.
We discussed the fact that you have an interesting skill, many interesting skills, but this one in particular, I think, really is a great party trick.
Talk about picking stuff up.
Yeah, Scotty, I know you saw this firsthand. Ryan says that he can balance a Christmas tree on the palm of his hand like we are seeing here. So was that impressive when you saw that?
It looks like me.
Yeah.
I was like, wait, what? Is that really happening?
It's a thing.
I mean, apparently it's a thing, but we're going to find out because, you know, in the spirit of your movie's hopeful theme, this is what we're going to do. If you are up for it, we are going to count to 10. We've got a Christmas tree outside. Mm-hmm. For every second that you can hold that Christmas tree up and balance it, we're going to donate $100 to the Red Cross relief efforts to the fires here in California. Are you up for that, sir?
Oh, yeah, I'm up for that.
All right. We make our way outside. I want to remind everyone at home that the world premiere of Hope at Christmas is going to be this Tuesday night, 9, 8 central on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. Come on, everybody.
All right, let's go. Let's make it outside.
Let's see you do this, Ryan.
Okay.
All right,
here we are. Ryan, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, hit it. Go for it.
All right.
Head on over there.
Be good.
Take two.
All right,
you
man.
Got this.
All right, man. Did you warm up? Did you stretch?
Do you need
to? You don't need to stretch.
No, he's got this.
He's got this. All right, here we go. All right, we're waiting.
Ryan.
That's two hands.
Let me get under it.
All right. Take a second. Take your time. As much time as you need.
All right, you ready?
Yes, we're ready if you are.
Everybody knows how to count to 10, right?
Yeah.
I hope.
Well, we'll find out in a minute.
All right, 1, 2, 3, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Woo! Wanna do it again?
Come on, Ryan!
Well,
that's fantastic. You worked up an appetite, I'm sure.
He's a man of his word.
I know.
That
well
was
done.
Awesome.
We're going to reward you guys a little bit later with some cinnamon Christmas cookies. How about that?